welcome to the SWN podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. I'm in a bit of a different venue, a bit different location, because I'm in Dundee. I'm in a Dundee travel lodge. That's where I am right now, because I'm going to go see Fair City Wrestling. Fair City Wrestling, ArdlerMania, in fact. I forgot my notes. My notes are over here. So I'm so excited to go to the show tonight. It's been a bit of a travel down. Started at about 20 to 12 this morning. And the time is now just about 10 to 5. So I'm going to go in. Just this quick intro, just to prove that I've actually made my way down here. And then I'm going to go jump on the bus to the Ardler Complex. So it was all exciting. There's 7 matches announced, which I've written down in my handy notepad because I had to go buy one at Typo because I forgot my own one. Including Andy Roberts, Craig Berry, which may be a UEWA European Heavyweight Championship match, but don't know yet. That's the mystery. I am just not in the centre at all of this. Here we go. Hello. We've got Yuji Maki versus Zach Dynamite, a match I'm looking forward to. Always love seeing Zach, and I enjoy watching Yuji Maki. We've got Sebastian Asher and Spike Tierney deciding who is the rightful FCW Junior Heavyweight Champion. Spike didn't quite relinquish his title, but Sebastian Asher was awarded it by Marcus the Glory Hunter. We've got Ian Ambrose versus Emerson Jane for the FCW Heavyweight Championship. Emerson's coming off a death match from the night before, from last night. So that's going to be interesting to see if there might be some blood spilled at the Ardler Complex. We've got Ashley Vega versus Brody Adler. Excited for that. I haven't seen Ashley or Brody wrestle live before. Two of my favourites, especially that I've had on the podcast. So I'm looking forward to actually seeing them again, but in person this time. I've also got Serena Rose defending the FCW Women's Championship against Debbie Dahmer. I haven't seen Debbie wrestle in years. Same with Serena Rose. And again, Serena, past guest on the podcast as well. I was doing a wee note. I think four people on this card, I've had them on the podcast, which is pretty cool. And I've also got the Team Hunter versus Team Williams, winner takes all FCW control match, etc. etc. Team Hunter being Dickie Divers, Deacon Matthews, Solomon Grum, and ADM, taking on Team Williams, Caleb Valhalla, Duke Cannon, Nathan North, and Retro Randy. So I'm really excited. Listen, this intro is probably going to be either a really short episode, definitely at this top end. I'm hoping to get down in good time to try and get some interviews and hopefully meet some people and we can get some stuff done for the podcast. I'm wearing a Caleb t-shirt, so I don't know if that will be good or bad for me when I speak to people, but we'll soon find out. But I say quick intro, just because I don't want to do an intro when after the show, because that just seems really weird and odd to me. But in the meantime, I'm going to go and catch the next bus and head to the Ardler Complex. So I might get some footage there outside the venue as I get there. And then hopefully the next thing you see is some interviews with some people from the show. And we'll talk about the show and upcoming show, which will be fine when I put this episode out in a week's time. That's the beauty of my timings and my editing and etc. etc. So yeah, without further ado, here is hopefully an interview. Fingers crossed. I'm here at the Ardler Complex. It's been a very long time. And I'm joined by Tom Atlas.
Why have you dragged me here?
I've dragged you to the toilets as well.
It's a very awkward Billy.
It's a very awkward situation.
Are you sure you want to do this?
Hang on, what are you talking about? I'm talking about...
You're the one who dragged me here.
I'm talking about chat for the podcast.
Just a chat. Yeah,
so you've been on a few times. You've got the fridge.
Somehow got out of the fridge, don't know how, but I clawed my way out, kicked everything.
How in hell, because I'm
still cold from the fridge, no matter how warm this is.
How you doing?
How are you?
Thank you very much for asking. You're the first one I've got on, the first person to ask me, I'm like, it's going well. So I'm glad to get you here, glad to be in person.
Hi!
Because I haven't before.
We're diving into the whole future job thing. I don't know what you mean. Future job enough.
No. There you go. Yeah, I just realised now that we've started recording. I thought we were near the toilets, but it seems to be where everyone's going to get changed at the same time. So this is great. Yeah. Exclusive of me, yeah. But no, it's just great. So I don't want to keep you all for too long because there's a show happening. But are you excited for your match tonight?
Absolutely.
Excellent.
I'm excited for it. I cannot reveal any information, but it should be a lot of fun.
Well, by the time this comes out, it'll all be out there. So you don't need to tell me, it's fine. I'll be surprised.
Ooh, fun. Yeah. Ooh, not ones are fun. I like them. I don't like quizzes though. Fuck your quizzes.
2 hours later.
Hello. Well, this looks like the start of something like a snuff film. So, hello. Yeah, there's no montage, unfortunately. It's cut off right at the ring bit because the lights all went down, and then there was a light like shone really like right at my eye line. So I didn't get pictures. I got one interview with our good friend Tom Atlas, Titanium, well, no longer Titanium Tom. So I just sat back and enjoyed the wrestling. That's what I did tonight at the show at Fair City Wrestling ArdlerMania. And it provided a lot of interesting, weird and wonderful at times, but amazing, a really amazing show nonetheless. I bought a notepad from Typo for £1. I've written in one page, which was the match lineup, and just I've done very little. So I apologise to those that are listening to this podcast thinking you're going to get extra interviews. You got one, and you got a really cool one. I really enjoy speaking to Tom. I enjoy speaking to everyone at the show. I got to speak to just about everyone that was on the show briefly. Just after the match, after the event itself, I put away some chairs because I thought, oh, I should do something. So yeah, I wasn't the most helpful guest at Fair City Wrestling, but the hospitality has been absolutely amazing by the company. So thank you, John, and thank you to the rest of the crew and everyone else for making me feel welcome, because to be honest, I'm just a guy with a podcast and I dick about. I was trying to not get in the way, and I felt like I was getting in the way, and that's just the life of, I don't know, I think I may have anxiety. So life of that leads, but it was such a great night. I will probably do something a little bit more succinct when I get home. Plan to record that section on Monday. I've actually got the week that this podcast comes out, I will have had the week off. So I'm just spending time with Jack and all that kind of stuff. And one of the days I'm going to see Busted. But other than that, I'll be spending my time with the boys. So I haven't scheduled any podcasts to be recorded. Podcasts would have come out. There would be an episode with The Wanderer and Arcade Violence that would have went out before this one. So there'll be a few things that are going out. I've got episodes lined up to go out until October 13th, and I've got a gap, which I may have filled or may have it filled with a guest that just got back to me today. So I'm hoping that we'll follow up with that. So yeah, the show features so many people that I've seen at the Ardler in the past, like Ian Ambrose, like Emerson Jane, like Retro Randy, people that I've seen on shows, Ewan Jibaki, that I've seen on these shows before at the Ardler Complex. I said it to so many wrestlers, I'm so sorry, but I hadn't been to the Ardler for about 10 years. So it's the last time I went to a wrestling show at the Ardler Complex. I think if I remember, I can't remember entirely, and I'm probably absolutely wrong, but I think the last one I went to, I think Viper won the Future Division Championship. That's the last one I remember going to at the Ardler Complex. So I went to shows with that particular company at the time, to the Bonner Hall, and I think that was it, the Bonner Hall. So that's the last show I remember at the Ardler Complex going to, which can't be right, but that's what I'm just going to say in the meantime. So it's been a long time since I've been at that venue, and it was a little bit, bittersweet's not the word, but it was a little bit like reminiscent. I liked seeing the venue, I recognised it, I got lost in it looking for the toilets, but that's another story entirely. But it was just really nice to go to that venue again, and I'd have a good memory coming from it. Not that I didn't have good memories going to that venue before, but they all got tainted by things, and really me eventually not feel welcome to go to shows in Dundee again. And that hurt at the time because, well, it didn't hurt. There's reasons why, but it hurt because I think I used to like doing. Go down to Dundee, go watch some wrestling, and have a good laugh with the people that were there. And then things happened, so it stopped going. And then I picked up a love for going to Aberdeen, and that's why I like going to the shows in Aberdeen. I enjoy the family camaraderie, and I really enjoyed that from the guys at Fair City. I really felt that. I felt that everyone was in it together. Everyone had a common goal, and that was to provide an entertaining show for everyone that was there. And they did that. They provided a variety show which catered to everyone. Every match, the crowd was loud. Every match, there was something to take away from it, something positive. Were all the matches to my taste? No. But that's not the point. If a match was to my taste, that would be, I would learn anything about my own wrestling tastes. I don't know. Is that a thing? I don't know. Because I like going to shows. I like enjoying wrestling. And there's always a positive that I'll pull out of any match. The opener was Zach Dynamite and Yuji Maki, which set the tone for the whole night. It was probably the best match on the show. I'm sorry, Emerson, but it was, I would say, the best match on the show. It was electric. It was so weird to see Zach as a face again. I have seen him as a face before, years ago, and then more recently he's been an absolute dastardly bastard, and I've hated him every time I've went to a wrestling zone show. So it was so great to be able to cheer Zach for once, which was interesting. It was nice. Tom made a little bit of a cameo, dressed as a bear, so that was fun for me. that was enjoyable, especially his little yell as Zach threw him backstage in a bear costume. That was beautiful. It was a beautiful moment. So we had that. We had, what was the match after that? It was Ashley Vega, Brody Adler. Great to finally see the two of them wrestle in general, because I haven't been able to see them wrestle live before. There was a lot of good stuff in that match as well. A bit hard hitting at times, a little bit rough and ready, I would say. But, you know, it was good fun. It was a good fun match. And then we got, now I'm just relying on memory. I've written down, but I've written them so out of order that I can't remember. And I did the results on the site, so I should really know. I think it was Andy Roberts, Craig Benny after that. And that was a beefy match. And as soon as I saw Craig wrestle, my mind was going, I want to see them against the Foundation. I want to see John Kerr. I want to see the Meat Factory versus the Foundation of the Future. The Beef King, Bruiser Brad, thrown in with Craig Berry. That's just a match I have to see. I have to know what happens. I need it booked somewhere. I need to see the Foundation of the Future versus the Meat Factory. And I think the Meat Factory would do really well with coming up my end neck of the woods as well, because they got a good chant. It's just shouting meat, but it works. Everyone was shouting meat, and him and Craig and Andy put on an absolute stellar match. I did think it was going to be maybe a bit, because Andy's really proficient in a lot of styles. So brawling and tech and everything you could probably think of, he could probably do. So I was thinking, oh, maybe they might throw us a curveball and go into a bit of a tech kind of battle, but they really didn't. They just hit each other really, really hard. And I really appreciate that, because when you see two big, beefy men, you supposed to see them just beat the utter piss out of each other. And I saw that last week with Dino and Brad, and I got to see it this week with Andy and Craig. And it's the first time I've seen Craig wrestle. I've spoke to him a couple times on the podcast, and I've always enjoyed speaking to Craig because he's got such a great attitude about wrestling. He's well spoken, he's very confident in his abilities, are very outwardly confident. Whether he's inwardly confident is another matter entirely, but he talks a good game, and he proved that he's just really good, and I want to see more Craig Berry in wrestling. Andy picked up the win with an, oh man, his Vader bomb was sublime. He got so much height on that Vader bomb. It was just beautiful to watch. It's not often you see a Vader bomb that you can call beautiful. That was beautiful. He also did a standing splash beforehand that got so much air. I don't know how Andy, of course, he put on a load of weight and then he shredded it and got himself lean. He's still got kind of a dad bod, but my God, that guy can get height. He can move really quickly. It looks like we may be getting something with the Meat Factory and Andy might bring in someone to even the odds, but I really like where it's going in Fair City, and I'm going to keep an eye on Empire to see more. I'm probably going to wait, when I do the write-up, I'm going to wait until it was announced that ArdlerMania will go out on YouTube, so I'm going to wait before... I'm going to wait and do my write-up once that goes out, because the lighting was really dark, like I was saying, with getting photos and that. It was really dark, so I just wanted to make sure that I didn't miss anything super obvious when I was at the show. I can add my thoughts and feelings as well on that. The first half main was Team Hunter versus Team Williams for control of Fair City Wrestling, and this was just chaos. It was just absolute chaos. I got to see ADM for the first time, so that was fun for me. He did get thrown away like yesterday's jam by Caleb Valhalla, which, you know, that was good fun. That was good fun to watch. I really liked that little bit that the ADM was always concentrating on fighting Caleb. That was the promo, it was his promo lead up to it, and that's what we got in the match. So that all works out for me. Game on, we're both eliminated quite early on, which is odd, and they're both eliminated by Dickie Divers, so I don't know if that means Dickie Divers got some sort of claim to the FCW Tag Team Championships, because that would make sense. He eliminated both of them, and I think he eliminated both. I'm sure he did. My memory, it's only been a couple hours, and my memory's already hazy. So I had that. Caleb was an absolute beast. Retro Randy was I think he may have got the biggest pop of the night, and that's not how... hyperbolic, it's accurate. There was people sitting next to me that was saying that Retro Randy, well, one called him Retro Randy Savage, but you know, Retro Randy was his favorite wrestler, and it was going about, oh, because it's such a throwback, it's retro, that's what it is, it's a tribute to the boss, to Randy Savage and all those big 80s wrestlers that people fell in love with in the cartoon world of wrestling, and Randy was fantastic, and we got a Let's Go Randy chant, so that was a thing. so we got that, and that was a hell of a lot of fun. And the match itself, as an absolute chaos, eventually saw Caleb finally pinned Dickie Divers to get the win, but there was so much going on in the interim. We had Kevin Williams giving Marcus Hunter a Death Valley driver. We got a ref bump at some point. We got interference. We got Retro Randy getting hit with a clipboard, which didn't really do much, by Marcus Hunter. We got a count out. We got Grum. We got so much going on, and it was just absolute wild. It was so wild. And then that led us to the first half interval, which was hilarious because wrestlers just kept piling out to get pictures with fans, but also get a picture with Marcus Hunter, who was knocked out on the floor through the whole interval after getting I think it was an air Death Valley driver for Kevin Williams, an elbow drop from Retro Randy, and he got something else as well. I think it was a heart attack, yeah, it was, by Game On. So that was hilarious. I wish I went and got a picture myself, but I always feel weird about those things because I'm absolute super cheap. So I will, if it's a backstage pass, I'm happy, or a photo of the ring. I'm not really one for getting that. That's just me being an absolute thrift. It was one of those things where, or in hindsight now, of course, I'm sitting here in my boxers and t-shirt, that I wish I went in and got a picture, but c'est la vie, you know? I also missed numerous chances of getting pictures because I was terrified that my phone battery was going to die, because I arrived at the venue with a 50% battery. So I didn't really want to take... I couldn't take pictures because of lighting, but I was afraid to, because I wanted to try and reserve some if I got any interviews, got any chats, which I didn't get.
So at the end, I ended up with Tom, and Tom was great. He was a fantastic guest. Love Tom. Yeah, even though he's a big dastardly bastard. I do love Tom. He's such a good dude. He really is. This is, we're past midnight now, so I'm gonna get soppy. But he's such a really nice lad, and he's putting in so much work. He's so enthusiastic as a in what he does as a wrestler, and it helps that he comes onto the bonanzas, the quizzes, and that. And he's just such an absolute character and absolute blast to have on every time. He's more than willing to be the butt of jokes. He's more than willing to be in the fridge. He's more than willing to do all that because he just loves wrestling. And, you know, if there's more Toms in this world, then the world would be a better place. There you go, Tom. I think I felt like you were gutted by our little chat, but you're an absolute wonderful human. So never let people get you down. I'm looking at my burger right now. It's still in the packaging. It's still hot as well. Yes, I've been talking for 60 minutes. Okay. So first half interval's done, right? Finding food, pain in the dick, right? So. I walked past a place called Vlals. I think that was called V-I-L-A-L-S. I think it's how it's spelled. I walked past it. It looked like it was just doing confectionery, like sweets and ice cream. So I walked past it, thinking, well, that's no food for me. So, so far up one way, couldn't find anything to eat. And I was starving. You know, I hadn't eaten since 12. Last thing I had was two vegetarian pizzas that I got at Aldi before I left Elgin. So I went back the other way because I saw the Tesco Express. Went back the other way, missed Tesco Express by about 15 minutes and closed. So kept walking that way, found a Chinese, three-star Chinese it was called, ordered something, ace, they take cash only. And I was told, the cash machine next to them doesn't work. You have to go to Tesco Express to go get money. And was I going all the way back up there, then come back down to get food. So I kept walking. And then I googled Vlals, and it said burger place. I was like, I walked past the place twice. So I've got it's called a Game Over Burger. I really didn't put much thought in what I was getting, but I saw the word Game Over. I saw Game On tonight. I saw Kevin Williams. And it had to be. That's the burger I had to pick. So I'm looking forward to that in about probably an hour when I finish speaking about wrestling. So that was the first half. I had a great time. I had really great company as well for the show. That's a car outside. I had really great company for the show that I was able to chat about wrestling with. I got to see a lot of people that I haven't seen in a very long time, like Sean and Tom, but it's just convenient that it rhymed there. I got to see Stevie Wizard in a place that's not Elgin. That was nice. It's just so many people. I've got to see the guys that do the FCW podcast. I got to see Duke Castle, Nathan North. I saw Duke Cannon, and I saw Patrick Patierski and JP, who does the ring announcing. Sorry, the commentary. Flash Gordo. Oh, Flash, right. Before I get into the back half of this, Flash Gordo is the most enthusiastic ring announcer, MC / MC to the MC, that I've ever seen in my life. And he riled up that crowd, something rotten. They were absolutely buzzing. They were hyped. They didn't need sugar. They had Flash Gordo. They had Flash Gordo just absolutely hyping up the crowd before the show began, before he announced that Steve Wizard was on MC duties. So amazing stuff. Flash Gordo. I honestly thought you're a fire marshal at first when I first saw you. Mainly because you had a blue t-shirt and then red like galluses. So I thought you were just doing a fire check. And then when you put on the jacket and you became Flash Gordo, my God, man, you are an absolute charismatic enigma. You are Jeff Hardy. You are the man. I've got so many good things to say about people. So I'm going to keep saying it while I'm still here and while my food is still hot. What was after that? So back from the break, we had FCW Junior Heavyweight Championship match. So that was the Undisputed whatever, Sebastian Asher versus Brody Adler, Double Duty, Spike Tierney and Sebastian Asher. You know what, it probably wasn't the cleanest match of the night. It was a bit, I use the word rough and ready for Ashley and Brody, but it wasn't, they didn't always stick the landing on the moves, but people really enjoyed it. They really enjoyed the show. They really were behind Spike. I want to see Spike again. Another one I really want to see in more companies. I think Spike would do fantastically anywhere he went, because, well, not just because he's really really good at doing the high flying stuff, and he was really clean in his maneuvers in that way, but also he's a cool dude in a mask. What more can you get to do to sell a show to children, which is you're going to be your primary market on a family-friendly show, than a cool mask? And backs up by just having a big, bold mask and costume and attire, and then he does some cool flips. What's not to like? So that was one for the crowd. I said that wasn't totally to my taste, that match, but I kind of enjoyed it, and that's the most important thing when it comes to wrestling. If there's a crowd reaction, a crowd noise, the worst thing you want is a match that I really enjoy and nobody said anything about it and there was no reaction. So I'm happy to withdraw any negativity I have on that, because people enjoyed the match and they enjoyed the outcome, and they enjoyed Spike Tierney becoming the undisputed junior heavyweight champion. I don't know how I'm going to put that in our results. Well, I don't know how we put it in our results, but I don't know how we're going to put it in our match, our title history either. So that's a problem I can have another time. It will be fixed by the time this episode goes out. That's the most important thing. I'm actually quite excited that I could put this episode out fairly quickly, because I'm not making a montage. So that's cool. That's fine. So after that was the women's title match, which was Serena Rose, sorry, Serena. I've been saying Serena so long that I was positive I was right. It's Serena. I found out tonight. That was one of the times where Wizard said that name, and I just went, ah, shit, I've been saying that wrong since Serena Rose was Serena Rose. She retained over Debbie Dahmer. This pup, again, was a match that wasn't for me. It didn't click entirely for me. There was just a weird, awkward moment with there was a referee kind of miscommunication thing that happened as well, and it was just, yeah, it wasn't for me, that particular match. But again, well, actually, it wasn't even like it was a popular outcome, because Serena Rose retained, so she could boot. But she seems to be carrying that championship with respect and. As a champion should, I suppose. But yeah, it wasn't one that, it didn't hit the buttons for me. I enjoy Serena and I enjoy Debbie, but the match with both of them, it didn't do it for me. There we go. That's what I'll say about that. I'm not going to dwell any further than because I like positivity. I'm a positive guy. I'm a positive guy when it comes to wrestling. And that led us to the main event. My God, this was incredible. Emerson Jane, who was held on by glue because she was in a death match the day before on Friday, this is Saturday, I was recording, held together by glue and a prayer, taking on Ian Ambrose, who entered with a cavalcade of skull-adorned people. And I think there was a Frankenstein at some point as well. There was a mini clown with an axe that cut his head off, and he was carried like a messiah. The entrance was weird. Okay, I'll say that for nothing. It was really fun. I really enjoyed the match, because I will go on record right now and say I think Emerson Jane is probably the best wrestler in Scotland right now. There's some really great wrestlers in Scotland, fantastic wrestlers. I sound Trumpian. I think she's the best wrestler in Scotland right now. So, man, woman, child. her and Ian. Ian is also a really great, great wrestler, so let's not take anything away from him as well, because you need a good dance partner to put on a fabulous show. And these two put on a just absolutely fantastic match. There was a little bit of shenanigans using Scully, and there was so much great stuff in this match, and hard hitting moments and suplexes and everything that you could hope for in the match. We got to see some of Emerson's cool stuff with the cartwheel counter on the middle rope. We got to see Shadowfax, I don't think I've seen Shadowfax live in person, so it was so cool to see that. I think possibly the last time I was at the Ardler, these two were either wrestling each other or in a tag team match, maybe one of the last times I was at the Ardler, they were involved in a match, and it was just great to see them again. And genuinely, it is an absolute pleasure to see Emerson Jane wrestle when I can, because I don't see it often enough live and in person, and she's an incredible wrestler that I was had the pleasure to see. Was able to get a chat with her afterwards. Obviously not recorded, but it's just really nice to speak to her. Nice to speak to everyone that I got to. I think I ticked off everyone, pretty much. At least got to shake hands with just about everyone. I think possibly Dickie Divers and Sebastian Asher were the only two I didn't grab. I've dropped a pen that I didn't grab, but everyone else I was able to at least get a moment with, and handshake, hello, and all that, which is just quite a lot for me, because I've mentioned numerous times I'm a very awkward person in real life. So if I didn't say hello and you think that I was slighting you, I absolutely was not. So if I can say that. I can promise you that I wasn't. I'm just very awkward, and I am working on it one handshake at a time, one chat at a time, one dragging poor young wrestlers into a crevice in next to toilets and speaking to them. So again, sorry, Tom. So it was just, yeah, I'm trying my best to try and be a bit more outgoing at shows, and that's why I'm trying to do on-site, on-location interviews, because that's one way for me to try. Because I've been doing the podcast for that long, where I've been speaking to wrestlers side by side on a Zoom screen, on a Zoom call, and I'm fairly comfortable doing those chats. But when it comes to face-to-face, my mind goes... Oh, I didn't speak to Serena either. When it comes to face-to-face, I struggle a lot with that. So I'm gonna keep trying. I think that's probably my aim in wrestling. I do a podcast. I have very fleeting interest in doing something in ring, but not enough for me to actually do anything about it. I think the thing I can do, though, is hold a microphone, speak to wrestlers, and get their reactions. I think that's probably my destination in life in wrestling. And I'm putting the reel together to prove that I can do that. And that's what I'm doing with the on location stuff. And I hope I'm doing okay. I know I need to improve on some stuff, maybe asking good questions, maybe working on my facial expressions, stuff like that, but it's all work that I'm doing to continue to support and support wrestling, because that's the thing that keeps me sane at times. A lot of things happen in real life, and wrestling is the thing that I go to when life's stressful, and I want to continue to give back what I can, and that's what I will continue to do. So I think I need to go eat some food. So I'm going to go do that, because it's still hot, but it's not as hot as it was when I started this video half an hour ago. So I'm going to, and I'm very aware that I have not looked at the camera the whole time. I've looked at myself and I'm on screen, and that's just very rude. So it's going to be very awkward to watch as a video podcast. I don't know what I'm going to do in the next section, whether I'm going to do another little bit in the morning, whether I'm going to record some bits while I'm in Dundee tomorrow. I wanted to get a little video scan of the Ardler complex. Didn't do that. To be honest, I've been absolutely shocking, and I apologise to that as a viewer. But it's been a great night. It's been a great show. It is 12:30 in the. It's 12:00, whatever. I have not drank any alcohol. If you want to know, I have a Coke Zero. I have drank one as I was taking my food back to the hotel, and I'm going to drink that other one now while I'm eating my goddamn burger. I'm going to go do that. Thank you for continuing to support SWN. If I don't do another section of this, this will be the end of it. If it's not, this is very awkward for me to wrap up. It'll go, and then I might hear again. But I hope everyone enjoys what we provide and what we've done here. Hope you enjoy the road trips. Next one is end of October. It's Halloween Hijinks. I've got two in a row. I've got Halloween Hijinks, and I've got Wrestling Showdown 2. That'll be the two back-to-back. Wrestling Showdown 2 is probably going to be a short episode as well, because it's in Elgin. So it's right next to my house, pretty much. So we don't do a lot of road tripping. But I'll see. I'm hoping to take my brother to it, because he likes going to the wrestling. But if I don't take him, I'm going to see if I'll get some interviews at the interval. As the guys at W3L are really accommodative for that sort of thing. And then after that, I think it's Christmas Chaos at the moment. So there's a big gap of episodes. So there'll be quite a few pit stops probably in the interim for that. And then possibly a quiz. I think that's might be how I finish off the year. And we'll do the SWN 100. I might extend that to 150 this year to see what the lineup's like. I am absolutely fading out now, so I'm definitely going this time. So see you in the next part if there is one. If not, it's the cool theme music that's not bagpipes anymore, because Rob still ruined that. Anyway, have a good one. Well, this is the I've got Jack here. This is the amazing back end of the SWN podcast. This is Monday. Sunday was an absolute hellscape. So got up, got breakfast. Travel lodge was great. So no problems with that at all. I had a great room. Very accommodating. Had a good breakfast. Had a hot chocolate as well. So, and because I don't drink your coffee, so I had that. It was all good. My train was supposed to be at 20 to 4, because I just went for the cheapest ticket. I went for the cheapest one. So that was, I thought, okay, right, okay, time to kill. There's not a lot to do in Dundee, is there? So I left the hotel at 10:20. I really should have just rinsed the checkout time to 12. In hindsight, I should have done that. But I thought, oh, it's fine, I'll have plenty to do. I'll do a lot of stuff. I didn't do a lot of stuff. I walked a lot. But I did. Just a lot of walking. Taking my hoodie off, put my hoodie back on. Then got too hot, take it off. And then got too cold, put it on. So that was the fun stuff I had going on there. Train was supposed to be at 20 to 4. And then got delayed to 5:15. But we just hopped on an earlier ScotRail. So if there's any lesson to be learned here, even if the ticket is cheaper, get the best deal. pay a little extra for quality. I don't know. I haven't really thought of a good tagline, and I'm very sorry. I'm just realizing that every so often you're going to hear a bottle going, I know, which is great ASMR for you. But no, it's been a weird episode of the SWN podcast, because there's been no montage. There's been no real seeing what happened at the Fair City Wrestling show. I did a lot of rambling in the last bit, which is about 30 minutes long, so I don't think I'm not going to keep rambling for you. If you got any, I should have a write-up in soon. Like I said in the last bit, I think I'm going to wait until the show goes on YouTube, and then I can kind of watch it back a little bit with some fresher eyes and remember my thoughts and feels from the time that I went to go see it. But it was a good night, a really good night. Oh, and I will say that burger that I was banging on about having, that from Villal's
something like that, was ace. It was the game over, a couple patties, cheese, jalapenos, some sort of sauce. My God, it was beautiful. It was exactly what I was needing. I wanted a big dirty burger before I went to bed, and that's what I damn well got. And if I go back down, that's probably where I'll go again for a bit of post-show food if I'm staying at a Travelodge. It was stupid for me though, because I looked at the map afterwards and realised if I just kept walking straight for another 10 minutes, I would have been like at the town centre. Idiot. My geography is not a strong point. It's really not a strong suit for me. I don't have a good sense of direction at all. So there's that. So next road trip podcast will be Halloween hijinks. Let's see if I can successfully record the first bit without the camera falling on me again. I'm hoping to get some chats again. Apologies for that bit of ASMR. Next bit is Halloween hijinks. That'll be the next one. Hoping to get some chats there at that show. And then it'll be W3L. It'll be Wrestling Showdown 2, the episode will be called. It'll be the premiere. That'll be on October 22nd. So, again, it's an afternoon show, so I might get some chats. I might not. I'll just see what I can get and what I can get at the show. The W3L are usually very accommodating when I ask. So I'm hoping we get something there. Noel on the show, Mayhem Brooks, is looking to win the Breakout Championship against Craig Stevens. And then we've got Joey Legends in action. We've got Johnny Storm. So if I get Johnny Storm, that would be amazing. And possibly something between Mike Russo and Luke King Sharp as well. That was teased at the last event. So then that was our first episode of this particular season. For now, though, Jack's going for a nap. And after yesterday's travel fun, I'm probably going to go do the same and then go edit this episode, put out on Friday. But again, thank you very much for everyone that's supporting the SWN podcast. It has been so appreciated. Go check out on social media. Go on Patreon as well. Like I said, this is a bit of a weird road trip episode because it's unlike how they've gone before with photos and the montage, and you just rely on just me speaking constantly. But I'm just going to leave you to it. It's been like a 40 minute episode, and it's just me speaking. Nobody wants that. Right, have a good one, guys. Bye.